a bad feeling about this place.
We have our orders from Kandaris.
That doesn't mean I have to like them.
Never mind Kandaris. The commander isn't going to be happy with us if we don't find those Jedi.
Too late. There's the commander now. Report.
No luck, Commander. The strange energy in this place is interfering with our sensor readings.
Kandaris does not like excuses,
and Mandalore likes them even less. You know how Mandalore deals with failure.
But Commander... Enough. No thanks to you two, I've detected some faint readings on the other side of this ridge. Prepare your stealth generators. Those Jedi won't know what hit them.
We might have something to say about that.
Jedi. Kill these Jedi scum.
The shots are getting louder and more intense. I sense a great struggle overhead.
Revan knows what he's doing up there. It's our job to take care of business on the ground.
Something still doesn't feel right.
It's just the dark power of this place you feel. Don't let it corrupt you with fear. Come on, let's get moving. Sensors are picking up more Mandalorian soldiers just to the east of here.
Starting to wonder if something happened to you.
I was delayed, unexpectedly. I'm approaching Malachor 5 now, but it looks like you started the party without me.
Mandalore was quick with his attack. They launched a full assault just as soon as we exited hyperspace.
I expected no less. What's the status of the mass shadow generator? Is Bayardur finished?
He's making some final adjustments now, and will be leaving the planet shortly.
Excellent. The majority of the Mandalorian fleet is in close orbit around the planet, just where we want them. Give the order as soon as Bayardur has completed his adjustments.
But there are still men on the surface.
Acceptable losses, Mitra. You knew the risks when sending them to the planet's surface, and so did they.
The risk was a Mandalorian ambush, not an attack from within. I did not sign up for this. Those Jedi...
Do not waste this opportunity to deliver the final blow to the Mandalorians. Activate the super weapon as soon as it becomes operational. That's an order, General.
I understand. Mitra Surik out.
Is something wrong?
Did you feel that? No, Taquati. It's something else. Something's happening!
A few sore spots, but I'm fine otherwise. The cavern we were passing through must have shielded us from the worst of the blast.
Something is different. I can feel the force, but not like before. It's almost as if the force is calling out to me.
I don't understand.
I can't explain it. I feel so weak.
Here, let me help you.
What's happening? I'm sorry, friend, but the Force has its own will now, and I must obey.
The storms are quite magnificent, aren't they?
I'm not interested in the weather, but I did have some questions. You can start by telling me what this place is, and how I got here.
You know this place already. You discovered it during your journey through the planet's depths, but were too weak to enter.
I remember the structure now, but what is its purpose? And how did it survive when the rest of the planet sits fractured and broken?
It is an academy of sorts. And it survived because it is protected. The dark power of this planet is very strong, but you know this already.
What I know is that I don't plan on spending another minute here.
You cannot leave, not until you are ready.
You can't keep me captive here.
It is my hope that you will choose to stay, especially after you see what I have to offer you.
Huh. You're crazy if you think I want to stay here. I'm a Jedi, and I must return to the Order.
Ah, but are you sure they will even take you back? You've seen where the path of the light has led you. There are other avenues to the Force, you know. It is time you put your Jedi past behind you and set your new destiny into motion.
You are of the Sith. I will not be corrupted by your teachings.
I had a feeling you would react this way. So be it. It is time to teach you your first lesson.
Teach this.
You cannot defeat me in this place. End this.
I'm planning on it.
Your strength weakens more with each moment that you resist.
I will not give in to the dark side.
It is too late for that. I know what happened on the planet's surface with your Jedi companions. You are slowly giving in to the dark side already. Look deep inside. You are changed.
How did this happen?
The dark power of this place is very strong. It did not take much for you to turn once the Jedi turned on you. Once Revan turned on you.
I don't believe you. Revan would not condone genocide of his own people.
Then you do not know Revan as well as you think. He does not care about you. You are a pawn in the greater plan, one that extends far beyond this place.
That's impossible. Revan wouldn't do this.
The Revan you knew no longer exists. The dark power of this place has changed him as well. But with great power also came great vision. And Revan saw the Force as it was meant to be seen, without regard to light or dark.
Who are you? And how do you know all of this?
I am the keeper of this place, and one of Revan's disciples. One of many that he has secretly trained so that his army will be ready for the true threat that is to come.
The only threat I see is you, Sith.
Sith? No, I am not Sith, but I am not Jedi either. We are something greater, something more powerful, something forged to bring balance and stability to the galaxy. The Mandalorian Wars were just a front for a larger conflict. Revan has discovered the true evil in the galaxy, and he and his army have now gone where no Jedi has gone before to confront it.
If this threat is as powerful as you make it out to be, then why didn't he take you with him?
There were many that Revan did not take with him. The ones he sacrificed in the final battle were those whose loyalties to him remained in doubt, including you. Yet, there were others that chose a different path and did not follow him.
Which others?
His top general chose to remain behind. Revan let her go so she could show the Jedi Council the hypocrisy of their failed teachings.
Top general? You are referring to Mitra Surik. What does she have to do with any of this?
You don't know, do you? Look around at all the destruction. This is her doing. The hunger you feel, it is a manifestation of the planet's destruction that she caused.
No, I don't believe it.
Look at yourself if you need more proof. She now roams free while you are confined to this planet, forced to absorb life from others just to sustain yourself. Your affliction is a painful burden to bear, but can become a powerful technique as well. But it can also lead to your undoing if not managed properly. We can help you control your hunger. But you must promise to remain here at this academy.
We? What do you mean, we?
By we, I also speak of the one that found you. She is very strong in the Force, and her power continues to grow with each day she resides in this place. She has trained others powerful in the Force, and she can train you to harness your power as well.
I can't. I will not.
Even now, the hunger consumes you, weakens you. If you hope to survive, you must give in to your hate, give in to your anger, and embrace the full power of this place. With her aid, she can teach you to channel your hunger. But for now, you must rest.
Yes? Have you come with questions?
I just spoke to Atten. We're coming up on Onderon.
What is it?
Something has been on my mind since we left Korriban.
Ask, and I will answer.
Cyan, you knew him already on Pyrogus. Then, on Korriban, he said he knew you. But it was more than that. He said he knew you as an apprentice knows their master. Is it true? Are you Sith?
Does it matter? Of course it does. Such titles allow you to break the galaxy into light and dark, categorize it. Perhaps I am neither, and I hold both as what they are, pieces of a whole. Know that I am your teacher, and that is enough.
If we're going to continue traveling together, then it's important there are no secrets between us.
What do you wish to hear? That I once believed in the Code of the Jedi? That I felt the call of the Sith, that perhaps once I held the galaxy by its throat, that for every good work that I did, I brought equal harm upon the galaxy, that perhaps what the greatest of the Sith Lords knew of evil they learned from me. What would it matter now? There is only so much comfort in knowing such things, and it is not who I am now.
You know all about my past. It's only fitting I know yours.
Perhaps we will discuss more. There are dark places in the galaxy where few tread, ancient centers of learning, of knowledge. But I did not walk alone. To be united by hatred is a fragile alliance at best. My will is not law. Disagreements, ambition, and hunger for power. There are techniques within the Force against which there is no defense. Mistakes, and use that knowledge to become greater than I. That is all I ask of you, and that is all I desire. In you, all my hopes rest for the future, for the Force.
Well, this is Onderon. It looks like there's a long line to get into the Isis starport.
We've arrived.
Thank you.
Something feels wrong here. A great disturbance here in orbit, and again on the planets below.
I guess this blockade is a symptom of larger problems on Onderon. Looks like we're about to find out. I'm receiving a message from some Colonel Tobin. Patching it through.
The Ebon Hawk. I was told to expect your arrival. I don't know your business on Onderon, but it ends here.
We've taken some hits. We can try to fight back, or I can outrun them and hide us on the jungle moon nearby. It's your call.
I can't keep us in one piece much longer.
Sorry to spoil your fun, but we've got to land now. I'm gonna put us down on that jungle moon.
You know, just once I wish someone was glad to see us. But no, if it isn't weapons pointed at our heads, it's someone trying to blast us out of the sky.
I remember the days when welcoming committee used to mean something, without being followed by blaster bolts.
So what now?
Well, the space battle's still going on overhead. Since they were so eager to use our hull for target practice, I doubt they're just going to forget us. Well, I don't like it. Onderon is about as far from the core as you can get and still be in the Republic. But even out here, the locals have heard of us.
We're lucky I was able to find this place to land. Looks like something has cleared away the jungle in a few spots around here.
Where did we land?
Looks like one of the moons of Onderon. Not sure which one. It's mostly jungle and mountain. I did pick up the remains of an old outpost near here. Maybe that's why there's all these clearings around. Maybe they were once settlements.
There were no settlements here. Those clearings were most likely once craters or crash sites.
Crash sites?
This is Duxon, where the Mandalorians began their crusade against the Republic. The remains of whatever outposts you detected here are military ones. We should be careful.
This is where the Mandalorian War started?
This doesn't look like much of a battlefield.
Much is buried here, and there is much that should remain buried.
How badly is the ship damaged?
It's taken a little damage, nothing too serious. I'm shutting down all unnecessary systems until we make repairs. It'll keep us from being a target.
How long until we can get moving? We need to get to Onderon and Master Kavar.
Until the ship is repaired, we're not going anywhere. Unless you can find another route to Onderon, we should sit tight.
There may be a means to get to Onderon by another route. The Force has guided us here for a reason. We should explore our surroundings. There is something here.
Something? Oh, there's something here, all right. Predators. Not small flit darters, but big, mean, nasty predators.
Nevertheless, we should explore our surroundings. And that nearby outpost would be as good a place as any to begin.
Running around the jungle doesn't sound like a good idea to me.
I agree. Going off alone is just asking for trouble. Especially when there's no more reason for it other than a cryptic whim. No offense.
If we hope to get to Onderon and leave this moon, then we need to explore this place. We landed here for a reason, I'm certain of it.
Fine. I'll put together a scouting party, and then we can leave. But first, I need to check on our newest passenger.
I have a feeling the ship will not be repaired until our business here is concluded. Do I make myself clear?
Yeah, I understand. What's so important about this place?
This is where the Mandalorian Wars began. She fought here once, and there are things here she must see.
She fought here? Why didn't she say anything?
Do you speak of all your battles? Or are there some you wish to forget?
Are you all right?
I am able to serve.
That's not what I asked. I asked if you were all right.
I have not heard that question in some time. My flesh is healed, if that's the answer you seek.
I'm glad you're doing better. I didn't want to fight you, but you left me no choice. Which still leaves one big question. You boarded the ship at Korriban. Why?
My master was aware of a disturbance in the Force, but was unaware of its nature, of you. There is little my master does not know. and that you eluded his sight for so long is significant. But I do not know why.
Your master must be stopped. You will take me to him.
I cannot. I will not. His vessel roams the borders of known space, and even I do not know where he travels. Until he calls for me, even if I could lead you to my master, I cannot permit you to find him until you are ready. His power is great, and it comes from hunger. He is a wound in the Force, more presence than flesh. And in his wake, life dies, sacrificing itself to his hunger. And those who feel the Force strongly are beacons to his hunger. He cannot deny his hunger for long. And any gathering of Jedi is something he cannot long resist. And now that the Jedi are vanishing, I do not know what will happen. Perhaps he will grow strong enough to eradicate all life, merely with his presence.
You speak of your home planet. Atten said something happened to it, to your people. Your master did this, didn't he?
It is not a subject which I have spoken of since its destruction. I remember little of my homeworld before I entered my master's service. It is not as it was. There is little left of such memories. Or the planet itself. It orbits, dead in space. But nothing lives on its surface. It echoes, but there's no one left to hear it. The Jedi, the last council of the Jedi, came to our world to meet in secret. They hoped that perhaps among our people, they could achieve the clarity to see what was striking them from the darkness of the galaxy. They succeeded, but only in bringing him from the outer regions. And KOTOR, with my kind, with the Jedi upon its surface, could no longer be ignored. And my people died, and the Jedi died. And there was no one left, only me. When the life was bled from the planet, and yet somehow I remained, my master came for me. He walked upon the surface of my dead world, and there, lying in the bodies of my race, he took me for his own. And he made me see. He showed me to make me believe in his cause. He convinced me the galaxy, all life, must die. He fed upon its ugliness, its screaming, and in its place, he left silence. And where there was chaos, he brought stillness and order. And for the first time, I saw the galaxy, and I wished to die. My people, my planet, would have been attacked in time. It was inevitable. Yet we could do nothing about it.
We're going to do something about it this time, or your master will be the death of us all, of everything.
You will meet my master. It is inevitable. I have seen it. And when you stand before him and realize what you face, you must be prepared. Until then, I must protect you, help you, until you are ready.
Why are you doing this?
There's a greatness in you. A greatness that does not stem from the Force. It stems from who you are. And if my master does not understand you, cannot see you, then perhaps there is hope for us all. But if you seek to survive, then you must understand why this is so.
For the sake of the galaxy, I hope you're right. Rest up. I have a feeling I'm going to need your help sooner than later.
Forgive me, but before you go, I must ask. Why do you do this? Why do you seek to help me? Teach me?
Because I believe you can be redeemed.
Very well. Perhaps we shall speak more of this at another time. But know this, I cannot allow you to weaken yourself for me. If we enter battle, I will fight and die alongside you.
You have befriended the Seer?
I wouldn't say befriended, but yes, we were talking.
The Sith carry the battle to you, and you spare them. And as we travel, the empty places of this ship are filled.
I hope your thoughts in this matter are clear. If you take her on as a servant, know that the Sith meet their end at the hands of their apprentices. It is not something I would wish to happen to you.
This one you have saved has other masters. Though blind, she has ties to darkness. Her presence here is a threat to us, to you. Do not underestimate her or her loyalty.
Perhaps she does have ties to her former master, but for now I see her as an ally. Still, if the opportunity presents itself, I will not hesitate to take advantage.
Then you are learning. This one you have saved has other masters. Though blind, she has ties to darkness.
His progress has been remarkable. Such command of the Force. Shortly, he will surpass even your most powerful student.
Enough of this.
An amazing display. But does he need to drain the force from every assassin he trains with? Get me a few more assassins.
I shall attend to it.
You called for me, Lord Nihilus. I see. What do you require of me, my lord? I would not have come all the way out here if I was unwilling to serve. What is thy bidding, my master? Shall I track down the exiled Jedi? My apologies, my lord. Thank you, my master. I will await your instructions.
Duxon, it's mostly as I remember, but there's much I'd rather forget.
What is it about this place that causes you such fear?
I'd rather not talk about it. Forgive me. There's been a lot on my mind. First coming here, now the threat of Vesis's former master. Using the Force to destroy an entire planet seems impossible.
Nothing is impossible with the Force. It is an energy that flows through all living things. And like energy, it may be harnessed, channeled, and consumed at times.
Still, it's hard to imagine such power.
Power? Do you think so? You would be wrong. One cannot have power of that magnitude that her master possesses and still think and perceive the universe as we do, as most of us do. There is no strength in the hunger he possesses, and the will behind his power is a primal thing, and it devours him as he devours others. He is a breach in the Force. His mere presence kills all around him, slowly feeding him.
But if he feeds on everything around him, the Jedi will be just the beginning.
And when the Jedi are dead, he will feed on the galaxy, the Republic, and eventually consume the Sith as well. There is no future in the empty galaxy he sees, and that is why he must be stopped. The breach must be sealed before his power grows beyond what even we can hope to stop. I had hoped that you would not have to confront him, but her presence here has changed all that.
Which makes it even more unusual that she doesn't seem to be affected by her master's hunger.
Perhaps he is bound to her, as I am bound to you. If so, there may be a death served by hers.
You want me to kill her?
You must be prepared to sacrifice the blinded one. Perhaps her death will buy you the time you need to deal with her master.
I don't want to sacrifice her. There must be another way to kill her master.
He is already dead. It is simply a question of how many he kills before he falls.
Oh, there's something here, all right. Predators.
That Colonel Tobin stirred up a Minox nest when he took a shot at us. I'm still working on the repairs, and I have to take down some systems, including sensors. So you have to do without me for a while. I know, you're crushed.
It doesn't sound like you're making much progress.
I've still got repairs to finish up here. I don't know how long it's gonna take. Might as well explore the area and see what's out there.
Is there anything I can do to help?
No, it's nothing too complicated. It'll just take a while. Unless you want to be crammed in an access hatch with me for a day or two.
I think I'll take my chances with the jungle then.
Suit yourself. You don't know what you're missing.
Com says we've lost another heavy droid transport. How can we break through the Mandalorian lines without support? The path is mined and the place is crawling with enemies. I know we've got our orders to press forward, but we're at quarter strength. We can't, General. It's impossible. We need to retreat. We know, General. But we just don't have enough men to accomplish our objective, no matter how important. We already lost half the men just getting to the path. They've got the rest of the company pinned down by the crash site. You can't possibly ask the troops to go forward. If you ask us to charge, will it make a difference? Will our sacrifice mean something? We will press forward if you ask it. The path is mined. If you ask us to charge, there will be losses, General.
I've seen enough.
You let the ship escape? I will deal with your failure later, Captain. But for now, find that ship. Our ally has indicated that the Jedi hasn't left the system yet. Send a detachment to Duxon. If you find anything, alert me immediately. Now get out of my sight.
Keep calm. Their weapons are not raised. I do not think they wish to fight us.
I'm surprised you got this far. The jungle doesn't usually let its prey go that easily. What are you doing here?
Just looking for some rain. Have you seen any?
That was a joke, right? It'll be interesting to see how long you keep your sense of humor here. We have orders to escort you to our camp. Our leader wants to speak to you.
This may prove of use to us. Let us hear his words and see if they hold any value.
Take me to your leader, then.
Picked up your handiwork in space. I am Mandalore, leader of the Mandalorians.
That's impossible. Mandalore was killed nearly a decade ago during the Battle of Malachor V.
Mandalore is the name we give to our leader. Becoming Mandalore is the greatest honor any Mandalorian could aspire to. When our leader falls in battle, the most worthy takes his place. So even though your army killed our leader, it was only a matter of time before we chose someone new. Me.
But what are you supposed to lead if the clans were disbanded?
Scattered, perhaps. But we're still alive. Alive and rebuilding.
After our defeat at Malachor, the survivors spread across the Outer Rim, many taking up work as mercenaries, or worse. But they cannot have fallen so far that they will not recognize a new Mandalore has been chosen. One who will restore our people to glory.
You sound pretty confident for someone living on a remote moon at the edge of the galaxy.
We have suffered defeats before, but none like our defeat at Malachor. The end of the Mandalorian Wars was something new and unknown to us. Revan fought us like a true warrior and defeated us on our own terms. Revan embodied our philosophy and showed us our own weaknesses. Then he exploited them. It was a painful lesson. With Mandalore dead, our weapons taken, and our pride destroyed, many lost their way. But I will change that. Our spirit may have faded, but it hasn't died. It will burn bright again, like a star in the heavens.
And no one tried to do that before you?
Only Mandalore can command the clans. There was no new Mandalore for many years. Being Mandalore is the greatest honor for our people. Mandalore's helmet is passed from one leader to the next. When Revan executed Mandalore before our eyes, he cast Mandalore's helmet away, denied it to us. He took Mandalore's helmet and left with it. If he hadn't done that, the new Mandalore would have been chosen that day. But without leadership and direction, the clans scattered, fell apart. Many Mandalorians have fallen from the path of honor and are now no more than common mercenaries. But that is changing.
Possibly, but from the looks of your camp, your people have seen better days.
Covert camps are not meant to attract attention. Because we conquered them, the people of Onderon still hold a grudge against the Mandalorians. So we keep our presence here a secret.
Speaking of Onderon, I don't suppose you have a means to reach it.
So it's transportation you want. It so happens I have a small shuttle that's more than capable of running the Onderon military blockade. I make occasional trips to Isis for information and supplies. If you want to go with me, you're going to have to prove your worth.
I can do better than that. I can offer you free passage aboard my ship. We've encountered many species during our travels so far. It's possible we may find some of your people as we continue forward.
Is that so? I would appreciate your help. Many in the Republic look at the Mandalores as wild and violent Kinrath. There are two types of people to Mandalorians, allies and enemies. Right now, we are allies.
Does that mean you'll help us?
We have a long tradition of honor in dealing with allies and those who provide us aid. It's a tradition that those we war against are quick to forget. I don't want the Sith to destroy the Jedi. To survive, I'll help you. But as Mandalore, I have another duty, the unification of the clans. I was planning on heading to Isis tomorrow. But I'll move up the timetable and take you now. I'm going to talk with Zuka and have him start a shuttle flight check. After that, we'll head out.
Thank you.
they were sending a Sith master to oversee this too. We already have enough Sith here, if you ask me.
Anyone else want to offer their opinion? Good. Our allies have located the Jedi Exile and her companions. As luck would have it, she is already on this moon and seems to have formed an alliance with those meddling Mandalorians. Dispatch a group of assassins to their camp. Leave no survivors.
Is something wrong?
Perhaps, once having known the ways of the Jedi, you may understand what occupies my thoughts.
I know it must be difficult, being away from your sisters, but that's not all I sense. You are thinking about your mother.
It is not something usually spoken of in the company of others.
Then you wish to keep her a secret. But I have a feeling there's more you aren't telling.
Yes, that is correct. I feel that I may trust you with such things, so I shall speak of it. Though my father's blood I share with my sisters, I wear the face of my mother. My father was Yusanis, an Ichani general. He left our family to serve in the Mandalorian Wars, but his choice was not because of battle. He went to join my mother, one whose movements and spirit matched his. His only desire was that they fight together, side by side, for as long as there were enemies amassed against them. I never saw her face, and she did not return from the final battle of the war. She died in the battle that shattered Malachor V, and her body was never recovered. My father returned from the Mandalorian Wars, and did not enter battle again. He entered politics, a caste where one's battles are fought through words rather than action.
What happened to your father?
He was slain by Revan in the Jedi Civil War. When Revan sought to destabilize the Ichani worlds, Revan succeeded. The fact that our father chose battle is not shameful, but that is not the reason he went to war. He went to war to be with the one he loved, but not the one he had pledged himself to. He was disloyal. I am the mark of that disloyalty. It is said that such things run in the blood, and I have fought long to prove that this is not so. That is why I am different from my sisters. Yet I am pledged to them, and Atris, and I would die before betraying them.
Why are you telling me this?
Because when my father returned from the Mandalorian Wars, he walked as you do now. There was something wounded inside him. He did not speak of what had happened there, and with us he was silent, changed. When I look upon you, I see in you an answer to a question I have searched for all my life, and that is why I tell you this now. I do not believe you to be the monster Atris made you out to be. I believe your choice was my father's choice, and it was just as difficult. I know it is difficult for others to see why I am here, but it was important that you know one of the reasons, and know that it is not simply duty that I am here, but because I want to be here. I want to fight with you side by side for as long as there are enemies that threaten you. You are a leader. Your stance, your every action proves it.
How are the port stabilizers?
They check out Mandalore. All systems are green.
Good. I want the shuttle bound for Onderon within the hour.
What do you want?
Is all in readiness?
It is. Like I promised. Why? You want to back out now?
My only concerns are for the one you escort to Onderon, Mandalorian. Would you do any less for one of your clan?
Don't pretend to understand us. We Mandalorians are a breed apart.
If by apart you mean scattered, broken, and lost, then yes, you are correct.
Not for long. Soon the Mandalorians will be strong again, united as one clan under one banner. Mine.
Ah, yes. The Great Crusade. After the first one was ended by Revan and the Jedi. Such a defeat was merciful, an echo of the end, when your ships were in flames, crushed in the grip of Malachor V. But I do not need to remind you of such things.
I was at Malachor V, and I remember how many Jedi died to stop us there. And no matter how many dead orbit that planet, the Mandalorians still live.
clan Ordo still lives. See Kex there? He was serving on Nar Shaddai's muscle for the Huts. Kelborn was a scout for the Duros on Frontier Worlds. I brought them here, gave them a purpose. This galaxy will be ours again, I promise you. That is the future.
Indeed. The future is always in motion. It is a difficult thing to see. Perhaps there will be no New Age Mandalore, no great Mandalorian crusade. Perhaps your people fought their last battle at Malachor V, and you have been dying ever since, a quiet death that will last centuries. And perhaps all that remains will be what I see before me. A man wounded by a Jedi, encased in a Mandalorian shell, hunted by the thought of being the last of the Mandalorians.
You've got some guts talking to me like that. You think your age or your Jedi whelp are going to keep you safe from me?
No, Mandalore. You are wrong. I hope that it is you who will keep the one I travel with safe. You are loyal, and you have served many masters, even when they abandoned you. Do you wonder where he wanders now, Mandalore? Why he gave you your orders, then abandoned you at the edge of the galaxy?
How do you know that?
I know many things, and I can answer the question that burns within your shell, Mandalore. But there is a price. You must keep the one I travel with safe. She is important to me, more important than anything. Show the same loyalty you have shown in the past, Mandalore. If there is a Mandalorian crusade, let it be for something that will carry your people's memory into the future. So when the time comes when there are no more Mandalorians, then at least their honor will remain. The one I travel with has walked your same path, and I ask that when the end comes, that you remember that kinship, even if it seems there is nothing else left.
Forget the Jedi. Keep your eyes on her.
I tell you this in trust, and ask that you not speak of it to others. I only wish you to know.
Let us stand together, then.
You honor me, Exile. Together, then.
How are the shuttle preparations coming?
Mandalorians, we've got company! Stealth targets have breached our perimeter!
Wait a moment. I sense there is a disturbance in the camp. Our enemy has tracked us here. I did not expect them so soon. How did they get here, I wonder? Regardless, we must eliminate them all. None of them can escape. Our whereabouts must remain a secret. Let us join the battle. Our allies will need our help.
Generators, did you?
For Mandalore!
There are more of them!
Follows you on a regular basis. I think it's best for both of us if we head to Isis immediately. Grab your gear. My men will take care of cleaning up the mess.
Almost ready. Now we can go.
Vaklu's saying that the Republic ship attacked first? That's madness!
Unfortunately, lie or not, it's a madness people will believe.
The timing of this is atrocious. A space battle above our skies? So many of our fighters lost?
Curiously, only Tobin's men were involved in that battle.
That shooter!
Strong word, Your Majesty. But there is no good time for news like this. I recommend we continue with our plan.
But won't that bring even more followers to Vaklu's side? Increasing his power?
For a time, perhaps. But we both know he's not the true threat. It's his unseen support from the shadows that we must drag out into the light. Then, and only then, can we strike.
I fear by then it will be too late.
Here we are, the city of Isis. It's been shut down tight for months now. General Vaklu is close to declaring martial law. We won't be able to travel too far in the city. Fortunately, I have a friend in this quarter of the city. He's a doctor by the name of Dagon Ghent. His office is on the other side of the market square. The Onderonians have a mixed view of Mandalorians after we conquered their world. It might be best if you do the talking around here.
Talking? That sounds like a good job for Kreia. Just a joke, but on a serious note, we should probably split up. It may increase our odds of finding Master Kavar. I want the two of you to see what you can learn from the citizens out here. You're with me, Mandalore. Shouldn't be too hard, since you're used to being a step behind the Jedi.
Ah, so it's like that.
No one has a sense of humor anymore.
If that is your belief, so be it.
Fine. I was just trying to make light in a difficult situation. Let's get moving.
Halt, off-worlder. You'll have to answer some questions before you go into the city. What is your business on Isis?
I have no crates or cargo, and I'm not affiliated with the Republic. You will let us pass.
Why not? I can see you have no crates or cargo, and your ship is obviously not affiliated with the Republic. You're free to go.
Recommended a special commendation for Colonel Tobin due to his brilliant command of our armada in the skies above Onderon. Without him, Lord Dashiell said, the Republic attack would surely have done more damage. Tobin is one of Isis's greatest heroes and deserves recognition. The Council of Lords session is running late today as General Vaklu rallies his supporters to pass his amendment giving the Council the power to manage diplomatic relations with the Republic instead of the Queen. Critics say that this amendment is a thinly veiled attempt by General Vaklu to secede from the Republic. A supermajority of lords are needed to pass it. Political experts say that Queen Talia still has enough lords that support her to easily quash Vaklu's latest efforts.
There must come a time when the Queen bows to the will of the people. The Republic has brought nothing but war and death. In our 50 years of flying their colors, we have had more war than the past millennia. Back General Vaklu in his effort to make her see reason. We do not need the Republic. They need our resources, our world, and our blood. For all that we have given, now we get nothing. The Republic is weak and falling apart. Its Jedi, whose fallen brethren have brought such misery to us, have disbanded. Let's be the first world to take our future into our hands. Are you with me?
That's enough, Ponlar. If you keep this up, you're going to spend time in detention. You're coming awfully close to treason.
Kawanabota Ayuka Taigwa Kankidora. Yasora Ku Tuka Ulwanji Yuma Lifa. Shanek Ma Winbok Lelenko Sobaramwe.
Dahupa Bosakurata Go Jujutu Yoki.
kiata yamba wat ya yuki totune.
Ka wanabota ayuka taigwa kankidora. Yasora ku tuka ulwanji yuma lifa. Shanek ma winbok lelen kosobaram.
Kavadumpa munsuru ku plagliya wa. Bo bagaragawanda yaitua ulwanji yuma. Kawana bota yunta tanga kinamatura. Ta yaita ta bosananansata.
Fereki mangradu noko herete, jun sombo marampi no su klela so buto. Kristocho entisime soto.
Taracho mo sincho kava volpa muleji kumana minta barawamba michedos!
I won't remain silent any longer. The Republic has actively attacked us. They attack our spaceships unprovoked. What next? An invasion? Perhaps they seek to conquer us. Will you stand idly by? Will you let them bomb our city?
No!
If Queen Talia is so removed that she won't do what the people so clearly want, then we must show her with force.
That's it, Ponlar. We're taking you in. You've gone too far.
Brothers and sisters, let us rise up now and march to the palace. Our will cannot be denied.
He's right.
Get out!
Things are spiraling out of control. We need to get to your doctor friend now.
General, we have found them again.
Have we, Tobin? Or is this a preface to another of your failures? Consider the whole field, Tobin. Why would a Jedi risk all of this just to come to Isis?
The crew of the Ebon Hawk is elusive, General. We were warned about that, but we still underestimated them. But the fools are here, in Isis. The intel on this is certain. I'm ordering men loyal to us to take care of them now.
I think I have an idea. Hold that order. Have her watched instead. The Jedi may prove a solution to another one of our persistent problems.
Crime rates have been soaring in recent months. Even in the Merchant Quarter, the Western Square has seen a dramatic increase in violent crimes. In the Merchant Square today, a full-scale riot broke out. During a public speaker's address, vocal supporters of Queen Talia were provoked to violence. Captain Rykin of the Onderan military has confirmed over a dozen casualties today alone. However, seven people are still listed to be in a critical condition from injuries sustained in the riot. This is the second incident this week of public speakers being violently assaulted by Queen Talia's supporters.
Dagon Kent is the only person I know with the contacts to help us out. He's not the best doctor you'll ever meet, but he's well connected in this city.
You must be Dagon Kent. Mandalore says you might be able to help us get in touch with someone inside the palace.
Not many people can help you out with that. There have been several assassination attempts on Queen Talia. That place is locked tighter than a Hutt's vault. I know a few people, though. Who do you need to get in touch with?
A Jedi Master. Perhaps you've seen him.
A Jedi Master, you say? Now that is interesting. It's quite a bounty in Jedi these days. Not that I'm looking to collect, but if there's a master there, I think I know who it is.
You do?
The man I'm thinking about is smart, likes to stay in the shadows, and is cryptic as hell. If he isn't a Jedi Master, he should become one.
So you can get in touch with him?
There's a slight problem with that. You're dealing with serious politics by contacting him. If things go bad during a meeting, you may not be welcome in Isis anymore. Perhaps never. Just let me know if you want to go through with this.
I'm certain. Assuming you can find him.
If there is a Jedi Master in the palace, I'll get you a meeting with him.
Do you know when?
I'll check my contacts at the palace. I should be able to get a meeting with your Jedi Master shortly.
Is this meeting a trap? I can't afford to lose you, especially given recent events.
Anything could be a trap. Vaklu is no fool. But if the message is true...
Is this necessary? I can guarantee your safety in the palace, but outside these walls the General has many men that would do anything for him.
Nothing in life is certain, Your Majesty. But I feel something. There is a disruption in the Force. I must investigate this.
Very well. But please, be cautious.
Aren't I always?
That's what I was afraid you'd say.
You fought with Revan and Malak during the Mandalorian Wars? Why?
They were the only ones that realized the Republic would fail without Jedi support.
The Republic is a stagnant beast that had been killing its people for years before the wars began. Were it not for Revan's strength, the Republic would already be dead. Only Revan was worthy of our respect. We swept through the Outer Rim without any opposition until Revan assumed command of the Republic forces. Only then did the battle turn. But as you know, only a handful of Jedi fought, while the others cowered in their halls, afraid to meet us head on.
It wasn't fear that kept the Jedi from fighting. Revan and I are proof of that.
I'm sure there were good reasons. I'm not accusing you of being a coward. You commanded the Republic fleet that destroyed ours. You were a worthy opponent. You turned a demoralized, defeated mess into a coordinated army. You brought tactics, backbone, and above all else, victory to them. Ever consider what would have happened if we'd won? The Sith would have been nothing more than a border skirmish against the might of my clans. We would have brought a new age of strength and expansion to the Republic. With the wealth of the core worlds providing arms and warships to fuel our growth. Instead, the Republic won. Look around you. Look at what your precious victory has brought you. I ask you this. Is the galaxy better off for the Republic's victory? Just think about it.
I used to think so, without a doubt. But now, I'm not so sure. Seeing the destruction on Telos, the graveyard on Duxon, and political unrest on Onderon, and a Sith Lord capable of destroying an entire planet. I never imagined this. I don't think anyone did. Not even the Jedi Council could have imagined being forced into hiding. Master Vosh is already dead, and the Sith continue their pursuit of the remaining Jedi, and me. I foresee a lot of battles ahead of us.
Which is one of the reasons I travel with you. Our honor. Fortunes and lives revolve around battle. From our earliest history, this has been our way, as it will be always.
Are you actually enjoying this? They aren't even real dancers.
I don't understand what you mean.
The dancers, the holograms.
I know.
Yet watching them still gives you enjoyment. Look at them.
Worthy of a Mandalorian.
Ugh. Disgusting.
If you say so.
Well, they are. And Twi'lek dancers. So predictable. And their dancing is terrible. I bet you could sit here all day.
I could.
Well, that's enough for me. I'm going to wait for Master Kavar.
I don't blame you. They're sad people.
So, you're ready to leave, then?
Not yet, Jedi.
It was to the Jedi traitor Malak. It was to the Jedi traitor Revan. When Terrace was destroyed, it showed Malak's heart through its execution and intent. It was brutal, without finesse, but showed his commitment to defeat the Jedi. Yet with Revan, there was the same commitment, but it was a subtle thing, like weaving threads in a tapestry, or strokes upon a canvas. He spoke through battle and tactics in a way one could never do in words. He showed his heart at Malachor V, and finally, at the end of the Jedi Civil War. I believe he was speaking to Malak in that final battle, though few knew it. What stronger display than death, for conveying one's sense of being betrayed by one's own student? Revan's anger must have been great indeed.
To claim to know anything of Revan's choices, or what lay in his heart when Malak fell, is conceit, servant of Atrus.
Regardless, I would have liked to have been there for that final exchange and seen the truth of their conflict with each other, as perhaps you would have.
And whether Revan had any choice in the matter at all is something else you should consider. The Force is a powerful thing to wield or deny.
But to say that seems an untruth based on what I know of the Jedi. The Force can drive others, but there is still choice, is there not?
Ah, but at what point does the power the Force exerts submerge any attempt at choice or free will?
If there is no choice in the Force, then our teachings and our actions are for nothing, and I refuse to believe that is true.
You have taken a complicated question, servant of Atrus, and you have trivialized it with your answer and lack of experience.
Good. You both made it. Then I see you're continuing to make friends, Kreia.
And why is that? Please illuminate me.
Perhaps another time.
You must have gone through a lot to arrange this meeting. The palace is at full battle readiness. Smuggling in a message is no small task.
I have my ways, Master Kavar.
Kavar, the famed Jedi Guardian. The Mandalorians counted on the fact it would be you, not Revan, who would lead the Jedi against us during the Mandalorian Wars. I wonder how we'd have fared against you. I thought you were killed fighting Malak during the Jedi Civil War.
It seems my former student keeps curious company. Strange times lead to strange alliances, though. I have my ways as well. Why are you here? I imagine that you hold little love for any on the Jedi Council anymore. Even an old friend.
I didn't expect you would turn on me too, Kavar.
You have to understand that it was a time of great uncertainty. We just learned that Darth Revan was back with an armada. Every Jedi that went with him was lost, corrupted, and as dark as their master. And then there was you. Many thought you were a spy, but there's more to it than that. And I think you deserve an expo...
Am I interrupting? In orbit, I thought for sure that the Ebon Hawk was mine. I was certain, only to see you slip through my fingers during the battle. Imagine my delight to discover you were on Isis. Quite careless, if you ask me. Get them, men, and watch your aim. Civilian casualties cause a mess of paperwork.
I must return to the palace. I'll get word to you when I'm able. Run!
What? What have you done to my man? Blast! Men, take care of her! I won't let her out escape!
But I wanted to see Kavar, but that didn't go well at all.
It's gonna be some time before they forget about us here. No more trips to Isis for us until the situation changes. A lot. We should head over to the spaceport before General Vaklu invents some charges against us. Then we'd be in real trouble. The shuttle is just ahead. I think we should get out of here fast.
Well, that's three planets, three Jedi Masters, and we're no closer to stopping the Sith, or finding out why I was exiled. All I've managed to do is anger one Master, get another killed, and endanger another. And I've placed all of you in danger as well. You're better off without me.
Don't be a fool. Given the threat we're up against, we need each other.
You're right. Forgive me. We cannot give up. That's what the Sith would want. We are the galaxy's last hope. We must keep going. We must keep trying. Will you continue to follow me?
I will, Exile.
I'm not ready to part company yet. It sounds like you have a lot of traveling to do. So do I. The Sith have taken a particular interest in you, and you could use an extra blaster. I've been meaning to leave Duxon to look for other Mandalorian clans anyway. I'm going with you.
And I did say I'd help with that.
The Ebon Hawk is patched up and ready to go. When you're ready to depart, we can ask the guide here to take us back to the ship.
What are we waiting for?
Let us continue on.
Fire up the engines. It's time that I return to my roots. What is it, T3? An assassin droid on this ship. How did it get here? How do you know it looks friendly? I have a feeling you aren't telling me everything. Fine. But I want to know as soon as the repairs are finished.
Nice ship you have here. Where did you get it?
It's a long story.
I see. Well, you were lucky to get it then. This is a fast ship. Well made. I'll bet she'd have some stories to tell. I hear that you were the one responsible for our defeat at Malachor 5.
I was part of the war effort, yes. I worked as a technician there.
But you fought on the front lines. To a Mandalorian, there is honor in that.
I could do without your Mandalorian honor. I saw the results of your honor. The absolute destruction your warriors brought. And look at them now. Mandalorians are little better than mercenary thugs. And what's honor to someone like that? All they care about are credits.
If I were you, I'd pick your words more carefully.
You fought for no cause other than to spread suffering and pain to the people you conquered.
Maybe that's what it looked like to you, but that isn't why we fought. We fought for honor and glory in the heat of battle.
You did nothing but murder innocents.
The Republic took us too lightly. We wanted to face the full force of their army. We had to goad them to fight.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. If you ask me, you Mandalorians just got what you deserved at Malachor.
We fell into your trap at Malachor, and we paid the price. We were eager to destroy the Republic fleet and defeat Revan, so we committed all of our forces to Malachor, sealing our doom. Even then, we might have won the day. The tide of battle was turning when the Republic finally set off their trap. It is as much your triumph as our failure. We learned a lesson and we paid the price for our mistake. I hold no grudge against you for what you did. It is the Mandalorian way to respect strength. We were almost completely destroyed. You should be proud.
I don't need compliments from a murderer.
Fine by me.
I see you're building a new lightsaber. You must be fully recovered.
I am prepared both in mind and body.
What about your sight?
My sight has been damaged. My master, when he showed me my world, showed it to me as it is. It hurt. And since that moment, it has been difficult to perceive the Force as I once did.
I don't understand.
If you wish to know, perhaps it is possible to show another what my people see. What I see. First, you must close your eyes. The surface of the ship, its sights, will only be a distraction. Now, in your mind, reach out. Listen for my breathing. Do not focus on the sound, but the life behind it. Imagine its energy, its texture, in tandem with the breathing. And then in your mind, step back from the image. And see what remains. There. It is not as difficult as I thought. You learn quickly.
You constructed that pretty quickly, too. We'll have to get you a new crystal, though.
My master, Onderon is progressing according to plan. Tensions are escalating out of control, and each day more citizens continue to lose faith in the Queen. Soon, the people will have no choice but to support General Vakul. But there is something else, my lord. The Jedi. She has come to Onderon. Colonel Tobin was able to force her ship to land on Duxin. I dispatched several assassins to her location. They were unsuccessful. The Jedi is being aided by Mandalorians. Their leader was able to sneak her past the military blockade, and they made contact with a Jedi Master on Onderon. One must have survived. Tobin saw him with his own eyes. The General suspected that the Queen was receiving outside help, but he wasn't certain of the extent. Until now.
Yeah.
initial analysis has calculated the trajectory towards Dantooine. As you command, my lord.
Don't you ever give it a rest?
Yeah!
Fine, don't mind me. I just need to get some stuff from the cargo hold.
You know the first tier of styles, but you're holding back because I am unarmed. Tell me where you were trained.
What can I say? I'm a quick study.
You lie. Few know the Yceman styles by reflex.
Oh yeah? Guess you saw a lot of the world while you were freezing your cargo hold off in the Ice Academy. Didn't you, sister? This isn't some pleasure yacht, so if I did know all the Yceman movements, I might know more than just the first tier, including the etiquette rituals. So keep your hands where I can see them.
Fool.
Shut up. Next time I walk in here, I'm carrying a blaster.
What was that all about?
I am training, so that if danger should strike, my body and my reflexes will be prepared. That, and I had forgotten how long hyperspace travel can be. If I do not have something to focus my attention on, I fear my sanity will erode as well.
You and Atten could always play a game of Pazak.
What do you mean, Pazak? What, again?
No, I do not trust him.
At a card game?
That too.
I see. Don't let me interrupt your training, then. Oh, and one more thing. I respect your oath, but at the same time, you're no longer inside the Telos Academy. As long as you travel on this ship, you don't have to wear the clothes of your sisters.
I can see no fault in your reasoning. I do have bulkier clothes. Will this do?
It suits you, even though it's meant for a Jedi Knight.
They suffice for training purposes. They belong to my mother. She was the one my father followed to war. She was a Jedi. I never knew her.
Still, it must be nice to have something of hers, even if you didn't know her. We should be arriving at Dantooine shortly. I know I've been giving you a difficult time since Korriban. I just wanted to say...
You are spending time with the servant of Atris.
And here we go again.
I knew her mother. She was a Jedi Knight, a master, named Aran Kai. Jedi are forbidden to have children, and when the crime finally came to light almost a decade later, Kai was exiled. She joined the Mandalorian Wars after the shame of her birth was revealed. Revan welcomed her, and she was said to be a skilled warrior, beautiful and strong in the Force. The Force flows strongly in the blood of those born from Force sensitives. I doubt that Aran was any different. If the servant of Atris is of her blood, then the potential lies within her. If you train her, if you teach her the ways of the Jedi, you will be asking her to break her oath to Atris. It would be best not to train her, and let the bloodline die with Telos.
But if she's Force sensitive, shouldn't she know her heritage?
Should she? By whose judgment should such truths be revealed? I do not have such arrogant presumptions. The Jedi separate children from their parents as they did you. It is because family exerts a powerful influence on one's development. I am merely saying that revealing such things can have profound consequences, nothing more.
Who said anything about training her?
As you will. But there may be a point where you have no choice. You have a curious influence on those around you. Yet if you persist as you have, building her trust, then you will be training her, whether you know it or not, until the choice is hers, not yours. Spend time with her if you must, but recognize where your true loyalties lie, to the galaxy and yourself.
You don't seem to like her very much. Why?
There are countless reasons, and I have neither the time nor the patience to list them all.
I wonder if she'd like to stay at Dantooine.
No, she may have her uses. I will abide her presence, and so should you.
And why is that?
Because Atriss is a threat. And as much as she would try to use us against you, so may we use her servants against her. Do not see every enemy as an enemy. See them instead as an ally, whether they realize it or not. This situation may yet work to our advantage.
I understand. Before I go, there's something else I must ask. Lisa showed me how to use the Force to see. I was wondering if there were other ways the Force can be used to improve my senses.
Close your eyes.
I beg your pardon?
Close your eyes. Feel this ship around you. Listen to my words. Hear the sound of the handmaidens training in the cargo hold, her hands cutting the air. The welding of the droid as it goes about its work. Now, stretch out. Hear the rumble of hyperspace, the hum of the hyperdrive. Ignore distractions and focus on my voice. The breathing of the blinded one as she meditates in the dark. Now, listen deeper, past her breathing, and listen.
As my feet walk from the ashes of KOTOR, I shall not fear, for in fear lies death, and...
I can hear her talking.
You are strong indeed. What you heard were surface thoughts only, but it is something that masters have trained for years and never learned.
But how did I do that?
That is not the real question you should ask. Is such listening enough to perceive the world around you? It is not, because to listen to the thoughts of another is much like attempting to see the universe only with your eyes. It is equally limiting. Now leave me be. I must rest.
Alright, listen up, everyone. We have a lot of ground to cover, and I'm going to need you at your best. According to this droid, there are two main estates nearby. One belonged to the Sandrals, the other to the Metallis. The families did not survive the Civil War, but their properties remain. There's a good chance that Master Rook could be hiding somewhere close. We need to gather as much information as we can. The three of you would check out the southern property. You two are with me. We're going to speak to the administrator and we'll take it from there. Someone has to guard the ship. I know, but Dantooine isn't the same place you may remember. War has struck this planet.
With its Jedi protectors destroyed, mercenaries and salvagers are all that remain.
We need to keep the ship safe.
That's the spirit.
Welcome to Kunda. I am Administrator Turina Adari. You're the owner of the, ship that just landed?
That ship is one of the galaxy's fastest vessels.
I meant no disrespect at all. It is in fact a remarkable vessel. And unless I'm much mistaken, that's the Ebon Hawk. That vessel has been on Dantooine before, during the war. That was a Jedi vessel.
Let me guess, you want to collect on the bounty?
Of course not. I'm trying to stabilize an entire planet. An exchange bounty, no matter how abundant, is little use in that endeavor. But if a Jedi were here, that would best be kept secret. Right or wrong, our settlers blame the Jedi and their hidden enclave for their suffering. I remember the old Jedi Masters and the considerable help they lent to Dantooine. I still maintain discreet connections with Jedi. I suppose your arrival here is no coincidence, my friend. Let's just call him Frook. We've known each other for many years, and our continued friendship could create many problems in the current political climate. He came to Dantooine not too long ago. He was looking into something quite important. He's gone missing recently. Did he send for you in case something went wrong?
Right. I'm probably the last person he wants to help him. No, but I would like to meet with him.
Vrook and I had a mutually beneficial arrangement for several weeks. He went to the Jedi Enclave sublevel recently and hasn't returned. I know the sublevel is dangerous. I'm starting to fear the worst. Would you be willing to go to the ruins of the Enclave to look for him?
We'll make it our first priority.
We are fortunate that you've come. Don't expect it to be easy, though. Things rarely are with Jedi. I will have one of the militia transmit permissions to the Enclave security door. Go expecting danger, for you will most certainly find it there.
What's so dangerous there?
Like many parts of Dantooine, the sub-level of the Enclave has become infested with dangerous creatures. Large, vicious insects called Lagrex have made the sub-level their home. Several salvagers have reportedly been injured or killed by the Lagrex. I would expect a Jedi to fare better against the creatures than the salvagers, but Vrook has not returned in some time.
Do you feel it? The wound on this world, it is centered here. If we succeed in gathering the Jedi, they will come to this place. And if those Jedi are slain, then all that remains of the Order shall be drawn here as well.
The Jedi Order asked only for time to examine the Mandalorian threat. They urged caution, patience, and you defied them. The Jedi teachings require we examine our actions. Acting without reflection is not our way. You have not changed. Acting instead of thinking, putting yourself before the galaxy, before the Jedi. Do you know what you have done? I have your ship. I will return it to you. You must leave here before you place us in jeopardy.
We shall remove her, Mistress. Come with us.
Has there been any sign of the ship?
No, Mistress. Nor any word of our sister. We do not know where they travel now.
The freighter. It is important. And I thought the droid was as well, but I was wrong.
Mistress, we still do not know the significance of the ship or the droid. We downloaded all you asked, but we are still no closer to the answers you seek.
Then perhaps we'll need to have faith that your sister will change her mind, remember her oath, and return to us with the answers we seek.
I hope so, Mistress. But there has been no word of her since she departed with the other four on the freighter.
Four?
Yes, Mistress. The Iridonian, the Yceman-trained pilot, the exile, and the old woman.
Old woman?
Yes, Mistress.
I do not recall seeing her.
Mistress, she was secured for much of the time the exile was here. At other times, you were meditating, and we did not wish to disturb you. Mistress, is there something wrong?
I am tired. I sometimes feel as if things are collapsing all around us. It is just at the edge of perceptions, waiting. I fear things will collapse before our enemies reveal themselves.
Yes, Mistress.
I will meditate upon this. Perhaps it will clear my mind.
I got a bad feeling about this place. It's like a parasite, eating at your insides.
That's to be expected. I know Tatooine all too well. The Jedi had a secret enclave here. It wasn't secret enough. Sith forces attacked it during the war. It used to be a simple farm world. I don't know how it's changed since then.
This place is strong on the dark side.
It feels strange here. Calm.
Enemies surround us. Let's deal with them first, then we can speak. To battle.
Well, that was a lot easier than I thought it would be.
But that doesn't mean there aren't more of them out there.
That's for sure.
Let us continue together.
What is it?
The scars on this planet. I hear the screams of those who died here. And I can still feel that pain. And I can hear Master Atris saying it's all my fault. Tell me, did you know her?
Atris herself is not as familiar to me as perhaps she should be. Yet I feel I know her, yes.
What do you mean?
Because Atris's path is one I walked long ago, and it is a chapter of my life that has been read and closed.
You walked her path?
I was a historian once, gathering the relics of the Jedi, learning the ancient mysteries. Always there were more questions. One quickly learns that the Jedi Code does not give all the answers. If you are to truly understand, then you will need the contrast, not adherence to a single idea. That is why Atris and the others blamed me, sentenced me. Surely you felt the righteous anger, the spoken judgments, the lack of forgiveness. They believed me responsible for Revan's fall.
Well, were you to blame?
You have already asked much. I do not wish to speak of this any longer.
If the Council cast you out, how come Atris and none of the other Jedi Masters ever mentioned you?
Ignorance. And perhaps they do not remember or care. It is of no consequence to me. Or to them.
I think you're lying.
Am I? Then perhaps you should know. There are techniques in the Force where one can cloud the memory of others, make their presence so small as to be unnoticed.
Do you use that technique on me?
No. But if I did, you would never know. So my words only carry as much worth as you believe them to. But perhaps you will understand this, that perhaps it is important to me that you see me and my actions uncloaked.
I still think you're lying and not telling me everything.
Then you are learning quickly. Distrust is an effective shield and should be carried always.
Any luck getting the door open? You tried overriding the command lockout?
No effect.
There must be structural damage behind the door. We'll have to enter the sub-level directly and face the Legrix head-on.
Are you an angel?
I do not understand what you mean.
I wouldn't try that with a Mandalorian.
Ah, I'm just kidding. That's the worst line I've ever used. Hope some poor kid doesn't start using it.
Now may not be the best time.
What is it? Why are we stopping?
It's Mandalorian business, not yours.
Look who's walked into our camp, boys. Mandalore himself has come to visit us.
I am the new Mandalore. I have reclaimed Mandalore's helmet, lost after our defeat at Revan's hands.
Assemble the rest of your clan. You will return to Duxon. We must come together as we were before and prepare to fight a new war. A war that will return us to glory.
And if I take that helmet from you, guess that makes me the new Mandalore. I've always wanted to be called that. I know all about your exploits, Mandalore. We have fallen far in the past years, but even still, I will not stand idly while a usurper claims to be my leader.
It is unfortunate that you feel that way. Perhaps I'll be able to change your mind.
We'll see about that.
Any other takers?
No, Mandalore. We will follow you.
Good. I have no desire to spill any more Mandalorian blood today. Gather your clan and return to Duxon. You have seen the last of your mercenary days.
Yes, Mandalore.
You do that to anyone who disagrees with you?
Come on, let's keep moving.
All right.
Something wrong here. I can feel it.
I don't like it either. It's too quiet. Stay sharp. The archive is at the far end. If I remember correctly, this way is a shortcut. Certainly not quiet anymore.
Perhaps there was another way to handle that situation.
What were you expecting? This is not a petting zoo. Besides, I left my bug spray back on the ship. The archive is just ahead. I'll catch up with you, but there's something I have to do first.
Tu ne pudu. Rana nu prata dung no sercha e chua penki. Yin kin ku no ba muli rachi kun tung na bun shan yunyang. Kavadumpa kunpa yiya mokapata.
Kun Hunkami.
asked for it.
What?
Is that the way of a Jedi?
Oh, the robes. You noticed.
You have made a strange choice. A unique choice.
But it is my choice to make. The Council may be able to remove the Force from a Jedi, but they cannot remove a Jedi from the Force. With every planet we visit, with every battle we fight, my strength in the Force is growing.
Whether one can feel the Force or not has little to do with their strength. But I sense a disquiet in you, an unrest. Such things will erode your strength.
There are too many reminders here of war. Reminders of all the things I left behind after my exile. But leaving the Jedi Order was not my choice. Exiled or not, the galaxy needs a Jedi right now, and I'm going to give it to them.
One does not need to be Jedi to learn the ways of the Force. I suspect it cares little for our codes and philosophies.
It would care if it knew a Sith Lord was trying to destroy it.
Perhaps. I am not convinced.
These are lightsaber wounds. Master Rook has been here. But where has he gone, I wonder? Were you able to find anything on him in the archive?
In a manner of speaking, yes.
Beginning playback. Error. Recording partially corrupted. Resolving.
Today I caught her in a heated argument with my Padawan. Her master refuses to properly discipline. I want to know what action you intend.
Luke, I respect your wisdom, but it is not your concern.
But uncontrolled. Whatever the other Padawans see her do, they are quick to do the same. Other students dislike her intensely.
True. An average student of the Force. But with a unique strength, he's a natural leader.
I strongly disagree. Mediocre Jedi, lust for power, will lead to the dark side. Furthermore, it...
Remind me again why we're looking for him.
Oh, I had wondered if...
It was a rhetorical question, Kreia. Do you always have to?
What is it?
I sense a disturbance in the Force. Who's out there? Show yourself. So you want to play it that way? Are you ready to come now? Who are you, and what are you doing down here?
I am an historian and scientist working for the Republic, and a self-styled disciple of knowledge.
It's a dangerous time to be doing research, but that can't be the only reason you're down here.
The other reason was the ruins of the Jedi Enclave. Once I arrived, I felt it was necessary to stay, to protect what was left. Many artifacts were taken from the Enclave, both by raiders and others. I wished to preserve what I could, but these thefts, they had to have been done by someone who knew the Enclave well. I suspect the Jedi themselves took the holocrons and records, but I do not know why.
I think you underestimate the ingenuity of salvagers. Even the Jedi cannot protect their secrets from those clever or persistent enough. Besides, the Jedi who knew the Enclave are mostly perished, and the ones who survived would not steal from this place.
It was my mistake to use the term thefts. I apologize. In any case, if Jedi did take things, for the sake of preservation, of course, then they left no clue as to where they may have taken them. If I may ask, what brings you to these ruins?
We're looking for a Jedi master named Rook.
Then it would appear we have similar goals. perhaps we can benefit from sharing information.
The only evidence we've found so far are a few dead mercenaries. Their wounds indicate a Jedi has been here, but it's impossible to tell if it was Rook's lightsaber or the lightsaber of another. Did you find anything?
No. It is something of a mystery why they would exile themselves as they have. It is not the way of the Jedi to vanish in such a way, especially when the Republic is in need of them. I fear that there is something else at work, something that we cannot see. Then again, perhaps the Jedi are hiding simply because so many people hate them these days.
And I suppose you do as well. I don't think Rook came here to hide them.
Hate? No. I do not hate them. They only raise questions without answers. Jedi are not supposed to be like the rest of us. They are supposed to see a higher purpose in all things. And they are supposed to train students responsibly and well, so mistakes of the past are not repeated. Yet all I saw was ignorance and arrogance, and what those seeds created in the Republic. It is difficult to follow the Jedi Code when so few others have. But you know this.
I know not all Jedi are arrogant. Some simply wanted to fight for what they thought was right. But the Council still blamed them for the wars that would follow. Do you blame them as well?
There is no blame. All must accept. But, at its core, one must wonder if it was the failure of the Jedi teachings or the teachers themselves. Many of the Jedi Council trained Exar Kun, Ulic, Revan, and Malak. How could they not see the danger they posed? And if they could not, perhaps there was some essential part of their teachings that was flawed. Something beyond the Jedi Code that they were missing.
You know who Revan's master was?
Revan had many masters. Zar, Dorak, Master Kay before Kay left for the wars. Towards the end of his training, he sought out many to learn techniques. It is said that he returned to his first master at the end of his training in order to learn how he might best leave the Order.
Now is not the time to speak of this.
Then perhaps we should get moving again.
Before you go, I had a question for you. You came to Dantooine in search of Jedi. Why?
To get some answers, I need to know why they sentenced me to exile.
Exiled you? It is strange they would sentence you and not speak honestly of your crime.
They claimed it was because I disobeyed them, because I joined the Mandalorian Wars. But I know now they aren't telling me the whole truth.
It is not the Jedi way to lie. Well, no, that is not true. There are times when truth is concealed if they think a greater good can be achieved. But when such things are done, it is always done with the intention that the person they withheld truth from cannot be trusted with that knowledge, that it will bring harm upon themselves and others.
However you word it, they are keeping information from me. One of the council members said so himself. I just wish I knew what it was.
Perhaps there was some greater danger in you knowing the reason than in the reason itself. Strange. Mysterious are the ways of the Jedi. Sometimes they see things the rest of us do not. Other times, such sight brings arrogance and a fall. I will return to Kunda now and await the next transport. You may find me there if you have more questions.
Come in, T3. Kelborn, what did he say? He left a message. Go ahead and play it.
I received an urgent communication for you from K'var. Return to the camp as soon as possible and I will tell you more.
Yes, if K'var is trying to contact me, it must be important. We should return to the Mandalorian camp immediately. I'll alert the others. What do you mean you ran into a little trouble? Mercenaries tried to steal the ship. I had a feeling this might happen. I'm glad you and Beodur were there to protect it. One is still alive. We'll keep him locked up then. If he's part of the mercenary group we found in the Enclave, then he could lead us to Master Rook. We'll take him to Duxon with us for questioning. I'll be glad to see you too, T3. I'm just glad you and Beardur are both safe. I'll be there shortly.
This is more boring than hyperspace.
Sorry to interrupt your nature walk, but Master Kavar has made contact. We're heading back to Duxon, so I need you all back at the ship. Finding Master Frook will have to wait.
Alright, I'm game.
Admiral, this is Mikal. I have found the exile.
Atris was correct about you. You know war, its motions and currents. Only Revan ever demonstrated such skill in war.
It wasn't good enough. That last move, can you teach it to me?
Come. As we fight more, I will teach you. You are doing better. You learn quickly. Perhaps it is your connection to the Force that allows such things. Now you fight as an Ichani warrior fights.
Wait up for a moment. I've been meaning to talk to you about something. Back in the Jedi Archive, the disciple mentioned a Jedi named Eren Kai had trained Revan. Before we arrived on Dantooine, Kreia told me that she also knew Eren. That she was your mother.
This is already known to me. Why are you telling me this?
Because your mother was Force-sensitive. The Force runs strong in bloodlines, and you could learn to use it to help others.
I think I have always known this. It has always been in my thoughts.
It is never too late to learn the ways of the Force. Maybe I can teach you a few things.
I have taken an oath to Atris against studying from a Jedi, or anything of the Jedi teachings. My father broke his oaths. He shamed us all. I do not wish to follow his path. I swore not to follow his path.
Don't you want to learn?
If I were to follow a Jedi against Atris's wishes, then I would be betraying her for you.
I have fought beside you. You know me as well as you know Atris. What do you want?
This is a difficult thing for me to say, but I ask that you be silent as I tell you this. It is my desire to learn from you what you can teach me of battle. I have already learned much in our duels, but with every battle, I wish to know more of you. Your stance, your movements. I can sense shades of meaning and an echo of something I have yet to experience. Atris said that you were the only Jedi to have survived the Mandalorian Wars, that you had stared into the heart of war and only turned away because you were forced to. I do not believe her. I believe that you made a choice, as my father did, and that is important to me, more than you know. And you are important to me more than you know. I will accept whatever you wish to teach me, though it breaks my oath to Atris.
And so it ends.
I want you to teach me the ways of the Force, to become a Jedi Knight like my mother. I wish to hear what my mother heard as she fought the Mandalorians until the moment she died on Malachor V.
By allowing me to train you, you will be breaking your vow to Atris. Are you sure this is the path you want to follow?
There is the betrayal of Atris, and there is the betrayal of my mother and father. After seeing you in battle, I know you more than I have ever known Atris, and I am not convinced that serving her is the greater good.
Then know this. You have the makings of a Jedi Guardian within you, and it is time I showed you that path.
I will not let you down, Exile. I will honor you as I honor the face of my mother.
Betrayal. 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 Betrayal.
Has there been any word of her?
None yet. I do not understand why she displays such disobedience.
You know why. She bears the face of her mother.
She shames us all.
She has always brought shame upon us. In terms of combat, she is the least among us. Her stance always had too much passion about it.
Perhaps it is better that our sister chose exile rather than having it forced upon her.
Betrayal.
Betrayal?
Mistress?
She has betrayed me. The last of your sisters has betrayed me. Betrayed us. She is your sister no more.
Mistress, forgive us, but are you certain? She would not forsake her oath so lightly.
Do you doubt me?
No, Mistress. It is you who saved the Jedi upon Dantooine, who have collected their knowledge and hid it here to protect it.
But why? How did she fall?
She does not travel with the Exile. Instead, she has chosen to walk the path of the Jedi. It is the truth, and it is done.
You received my message then. A man named K'var wanted to get a hold of you urgently. He said that the Queen had arranged safe passage to Onderon for you, but I don't know how good their offer is anymore.
Did he say what he wanted?
He wouldn't tell me anything. Just that he wanted to see you. He said it was urgent, but that doesn't matter now. This morning, General Vaklu met with the Council of Lords and declared that the Queen was guilty of treason. He'll be made regent if Talia and her royal guard are defeated. The military is divided on who to support. Civil war has fallen on Isis. I doubt that Queen Talia and her advisor will survive until nightfall. The balance of forces seem to favor Queen Talia. The royal palace is heavily fortified and defensible, and most of the soldiers are loyal to her. But Vaklu has new allies, Sith soldiers and their masters. The war has also driven the caged beasts in the streets mad. Braylor and I both concur. She doesn't stand a chance.
You underestimate the Force, Mandalorian. I sense that we may still get to Master K'var in time. I sense there is something stirring on the moon itself. Tell me, have your senses picked up anything from Duxon?
Yes. Yes, we have. How? We picked up some transmissions from nearby in the jungle. We only have our shuttle sensors, so we know nothing more than that.
Those transmissions are the enemy. They are linked to the fate of Onderon. They must be stopped. Otherwise, the Mandalorian is right. Master K'var and Queen Talia won't survive this day.
Dividing our forces at a time like this is foolhardy.
And this is why a common soldier will never triumph against a Jedi. Your military tactics are nothing compared to the Force.
It is essential and inevitable that we face both enemies at the same time.
I have to lead the group heading to the Royal Palace, don't I?
You are correct. You must choose who who will lead the expedition through the jungle to find our enemies and defeat them.
That won't be necessary. I will be leading the expedition.
And who is this Mandalore?
The name's McCullough, Captain McCullough. This is Mookie. The ugly one is Muxie. We are the Mandalua. We have an elite squad of Mandalorian soldiers trained by Mandalore himself. We've been training for a mission just like this.
All right, but you'll still need our help. Atten will accompany you.
Hacking through beasts and jungles? That sounds like a job for me, as usual.
You should send two others to go with the leader. Who else will accompany the expedition?
I'm sure Vesis and the Handmaiden won't mind going along as well.
I am ready, Master.
Very well.
Mandalorian warriors will go with you to find the enemy camp. Just let me know when you want to head out.
Not quite. I'll meet your men outside in a few minutes.
You heard the Jedi.
Before you head out, I wanted to give you each a little something I picked up in the Enclave sublevel back on Dantooine. I told you we'd have to replace that crystal, especially now that you're fighting on my side.
The jungles of Duxon hide much in shadow, and there are places where the dark side runs deep.
Then take care, both of you, and may the Force be with you.
Is just ahead. The entrance is heavily guarded by turrets, droids, Sith soldiers, and assassins. It's not going to be easy getting to it, though. The Sith have found a way to control the beasts here. I've spotted several Momas in our path. There is also a turret system lining the perimeter. Stealth is more effective right now than lightsabers. We don't want to draw any more attention than we need to.
All right.
Be patient. Get your chance.
Thank you.
is crawling with Sith. I can smell their stench from out here. Let's keep moving.
Your friends are making good progress through the jungle. Trust me, this is worth the wait. And here it is, a salvaged Basilisk war droid. Mandalore said that he would make it available to you for insertion into the city of Iziz. I assure you, they won't know what hit them.
I get to fly a Basilisk?
Yes, just like a new Mandalorian recruit proving themselves into the heart of a war as well. Mandalore has given you a great honor. Unfortunately, its weapons systems aren't fully functional yet, as are some other unimportant support systems. But she will get you to Iziz in one piece. The fighters won't be able to stop that. We've modified the interior to hold three people. Maybe a little tight. You need to leave immediately. Iziz is in the grip of a civil war, so there'll be considerable resistance. They remember the last time Basilisk war droids visited their planet. Fight ferociously. And if you die, take as many as you can with you.
Basilisk here? Mandalorians are attacking the city! Talia has made an alliance with the Mandalorians. Men, destroy them. I'm not even scratching this one! Everyone down!
issue achieved. Statement. HK-47 is ready to serve.
I knew there was a reason I'm following you around.
Friends of yours?
That depends on your perspective.
That tank droid had us cornered. You and that assassin droid arrived just in time.
So, thanks for helping me.
All I wanted to do was send a message.
Well, you did more than that. That was a hell of a shot.
You're right about that.
Now, let's see what you can do with the entrance to that tomb.
Tired of me already?
You're a technician, aren't you? We'll need to override that door to get inside.
I'll have this open in no time. That? This place unsettles me. I feel an echo inside my head. Pain and anger.
This is the tomb of Freedon Nad, a powerful Sith Lord. He may be long gone, but there are many remnants of the Sith still here, and they are formidable. Moki and Moxie weren't so lucky, but at least they died a warrior's death. Mandalorians fought it to the end, and I have every intention of completing this mission.
I'm sure you do.
Come on, let's not keep our host waiting. We'll be fine, just as long as we all stick together.
Your plan seems to have succeeded. Your enemy has indeed revealed himself.
I anticipated the Sith, but those beasts weren't in my battle plan.
Even now, Vaklu is using them to breach the palace. I will not surrender to that usurper. I would die first.
Every man here would give their life to keep that from happening.
There is hope. It is faint, but growing stronger. I think my message was received.
Which message? What are you talking about?
An old student is returning. I don't think the Sith are going to know what hit them.
What is it?
A disturbance in the Force. Pain. On Duxon. We have to hurry.
Registering excessive system damage.
I'm not surprised. I figured that lightning blast would have fried all your circuits. Good to see you on your feet. ready and solid, and they're not in a good mood. Good luck.
Prejudice set to maximum.
Must not be interrupted. I don't need to mention the price of failure.
The source of the power of this place is behind that door. I have never felt so much energy. In the right hands, imagine what it could do.
We've taken the palace. How much longer must I wait for Talia's blood?
The beast's progress is remarkable, but it will take time, General. The throne room's force shields are far stronger than normal shields.
Our plans go well, Tobin, but we are still vulnerable until she is dead. Even now, it could all unravel. Redouble your efforts. There is disturbing news from the city.
As you command, General. Shut the outer door, now!
I'm impressed you made it this far, but you are too late. Soon the Queen will be dead, and General Vax will be the new King. This is no ordinary door between us. The same material is used for the hull of capital-class vessels. I'm afraid you will find it quite impregnable.
We'll see about that.
Now, if you'll excuse me, we have one last barrier to take care of.
You might want to get back.
Captain, we need just one more moment. We're almost through. Failure, Captain, will not be tolerated.
Too late. Our pet beast is about to breach the force field to the throne room. The Queen will be dead in moments.
Break the ritual now.
Watch out! I've lost control of the beast! ignore the beast. Into the throne room. The queen must die. Don't blast it all.
Stay down.
I don't know how you made it, but well done. We really need to talk. But Cadron and I are coordinating the defense of the war.
If you're out here, who's protecting the Queen?
I'm not her bodyguard. We got split off from Talia's troops by the currents of this war. We were fighting at the palace gates. There were too many of them. We'll talk when all of this is over. Until then, may the Force be with you.
You are too late. We have done what needed to be done. Soon, Onderon shall fall, and with it, the Republic shall die. But what is this? Ah, of course. The Force has guided you here. It echoes within you. Yet I sense it is untrained. It is good you have sought us out. This tomb is strong in the dark side. Here is where you will take your first steps on the path to your destiny.
You kill our friends, and now you want us to join you? I don't think so.
Are you so certain? The Jedi preach calm and serenity, while wallowing in weakness and hypocrisy. They would have you become puppets of the Force. They would have you deny the strength of your emotions. The strength of your own will. Can't you feel the power of this place? It echoes through you like a second voice. Accept it. Embrace it.
You're wasting your time here, Sith. We'll never join you.
A shame. Instead of freedom and power, you have chosen death. So be it.
Thank you.
not a mortal one, though it has been some time since I exercised my healing powers. There is a shred of life within you still. A gift from your master, no doubt. Awaken, Colonel Tobin. Your part in this is not over. Colonel Tobin, I am with Vaklu. The war has gone against him. He sent me to rescue you, to tell you you must make haste off-planet. The Jedi have struck. They had a secret academy buried on Telos, and they are showing themselves at last. We are all in danger.
What?
But the Jedi are gone. They have all but vanished.
So we all thought, but they have hidden themselves on Telos.
Out of my way, old woman. This war can still be won, and Onderon can be freed.
Indeed. This war is far from over.
Your time is at an end, Talia. Your people have abandoned you, and now your life is forfeit.
You would destroy everything just for your ambition, Vaklu. The Republic, ISIS, everything.
That is a gross simplification, Talia. Change is a painful process. A price must be paid. But Onderon will have a new destiny, one larger than you could imagine.
You're getting careless, Vaklu. One more mistake, and you're the one who will pay the price.
Damn you! Your skill with the blade won't save you from my men. Goodbye, Talia. Fire!
Your plans end here, Vaklu.
What? The Jedi lives? But how?
You'll find that I'm full of surprises.
Kill her and the Queen men, quickly. They must not be allowed to live.
It's just you, Vaklu. Surrender.
You.
So you are the former apprentice to my master. I can't say I'm very impressed. Lay down your lightsaber now, and you won't have to suffer the same fate as your companions.
Such suggestions are only effective on the weak-willed.
But I see much weakness in you. The dark side flows through every vein in my body here. You are no match for me in this place.
So you say. But it is not something I have observed or seen.
You haven't seen anything yet. Soon you will see the full extent of my power.
The Force is often effective in settling such matters.
Then we shall settle this now.
Thank you.
You've won this battle, Talia. But your reign won't be an easy one. The Republic is a sinking ship, and you're too attached to it.
He's too dangerous to leave alive. As distasteful as it is, it might be best to silence him forever. Until he's dead, all of Onderon is in peril.
I respect your counsel, Kreia, but the decision is the Queen's, not mine.
So what will it be, Your Majesty? Send me to your best detention cell. I will be free within the week, and vengeance will be mine.
Are you so sure of my decision, Vakru? I appreciate the Jedi's counsel, but as monarch, I decree you are guilty of treason. The punishment is death, to be carried out immediately. Captain Cadron?
Talia, you can't. You're too weak. What about my trial?
Your whole life has been a trial, Vakru. But it's over now. You are right. We can't detain you. Too many people are still loyal to you. You've left me no real option.
Men, ready blasters. Aim!
But you can't. This can't be.
Fire!
What is done is done. Onderon owes both you and Master Kavar a debt that can never truly be repaid. The war was brief but destructive. I will focus all of my energy on rebuilding Isis. Battles still wage in our streets, but by morning the conflict should be over.
The Force works in mysterious ways, it seems. There are times I'm not convinced it doesn't have a sense of humor. We spend all this time looking for you, and you came to us. I thought you might return to Onderon. Looks like just in time. I told the other Masters that our only chance to figure out what was happening to us was to find you, and try to understand what happened to you. I don't know how much you know about this threat that's striking at the Jedi. It's attacking us through the Force. Vruk didn't believe me. But he was willing to travel to Dantooine, if only to help the settlers there, and perhaps protect what was left of the Jedi Enclave. Whatever the reason, having us all drop out of sight, I thought might make the enemy more bold. But then you happened. You came back, and you became a new target for whoever was attacking us. I felt all along that Vaklu had contacted the Sith. I came here to find them, to trace them to their source. The war on Duxon and Onderon. I had thought that perhaps the tragedies that occurred here were concealing them.
But why Onderon?
They wanted to aid General Vaklu in breaking away from the Republic. If Onderon became independent, this place would be an excellent staging ground for them. But I fear it was more than that. That the consequences of Onderon's fall would have greater implications for the galaxy. This threat that is targeting us, drawing us out, it's not a battle we're used to, and it has ended many of us. I'm going to Dantooine. The Jedi Council vowed to assemble again when the Sith revealed themselves. Now that they've attacked Onderon, we can act.
Before you go, I must ask. My trial. I saw a holo recording of your meeting with the other Masters.
So you heard what we said. These questions I cannot answer. This is something the Council must answer, not I. You must understand. This is hard for me. Especially after all you've done. Did you know when I was training you that I considered making you my Padawan? I didn't. The demands of the Jedi Council were too great. But I considered you a friend. I even tried to convince you to become a Jedi Guardian. We could have used someone like you. So the decision that had to be made was not easy. But I won't say anything more. Our paths will cross again. May the Force be with you.
Out of my way. I am Colonel Tobin of the Onderon
Lord, I bring news of the Jedi.
A place where you may feed.
Telos, Master. There is an academy of Jedi on Telos. Perhaps hundreds of them. Enough to sustain you. And enough for you? Enough for you to free Onderon? Enough for you to free Onderon?
I'm glad I found you again, General. It's good to be working with you again. Having you here has an effect on me, General. I never noticed it years ago. I think my mind was too occupied then. The Force lets you look right through me, huh? They might not call you a Jedi anymore, but believe me, you are. It's not the sort of thing that you just stop being. You're stuck with it, just like you're stuck being the General.
Bayadur was always proud of the work he had done here. I can think of no better place for him to rest. Be at peace, my friend. No doubt Lieutenant Gren knows we've arrived. I'm sure he is still upset about last time. We couldn't just hang around though and wait for the Sith to find us. Besides, Gren is getting what he wanted after all. The Admiral should be arriving shortly. I wonder what's so important. Excuse me. I wanted to thank you for your help back on Duxon. Atten has told me all about your heroics. I'm not sure they would have succeeded without you.
Is there someone that you need killed, Master?
Kill someone?
Statement. It is my primary function to burn holes through meat bags that you wish removed from the galaxy, Master. It is only expected that when you speak to me, it is to give me the order to kill.
No, I don't need something killed. I just wanted to thank you for your help.
Statement. Oh, very well, Master. No doubt you are bothering me because you wish to interrogate me with harmless, non-lethal questions. Or perhaps you need the deck of your freighter scrubbed, or an exciting alien text translated. My circuits are abuzz with
anticipation of what your next task as if I don't have enough of that on the ship already.
Ending the life of an organic meatbag that deserves death.
Actually, I did have some questions.
Statement. Ah, more questions. Wonderful.
All right, now you can kill something.
Lieutenant Grant, Sith forces have breached the module and are attempting to pen us up in the compound.
Damn!
Zeron, I need you and your men to break through and lead the assault.
With pleasure, Lieutenant.
All right, follow me. Well, what do we have here?
I didn't believe it when Lionel reported the Ebon Hawk at dock, but I guess it really has. Though given the trouble we've been having, maybe I shouldn't be surprised to see you.
What's happening here?
It came out of nowhere. A fleet of warships dropped out of hyperspace, and before we could scramble fighters to intercept them, we were under attack. If you need to get to the Ravager, then you're gonna have to fight your way to the shuttle from here to the entertainment module, then make your way to the docking shuttle.
Join you in the assault. These rank and file soldiers will do you no good aboard the Ravager. Let we Mandalorians lead the charge into battle and to victory.
It's too dangerous. It's better if I do this alone.
You will not face this alone. I will go with you and be by your side.
So be it. Stay close.
I would have it no other way.
Sir, Sith warship dead ahead of us. It's attacking Citadel Station.
Let's close the trap. Concentrate all fire on the warship and deploy red and blue wings to engage enemy fighters.
Sir, at this distance, our weapons will barely scratch it.
We can't hope to match its firepower, but we need to draw it away from Telos.
Sir, if it keeps firing on Citadel Station, the station won't be able to maintain its orbit.
I am aware of the situation, Lieutenant. I do not intend to lose Telos twice. And I know that ship. It was a Malachor V.
Extensive structural damage, but its particle fields still maintain a minimal atmosphere within the ship.
And our cargo?
It's being brought aboard. Soon, teams will be dispatched to the target sites.
Do the Republic forces suspect?
No, Mandalore. The proton cores do not emit a signature the Republic ships can detect. If they do pick up the signal, they will assume it to be emanating from the ship's missile bays.
Did you get an ID signature on this vessel?
You were right about the vessel, Mandalore. It is of Malachor. It still bears the wounds of Mandalorian guns.
Then let's finish this. And remind the galaxy of Malachor V.
What was that about?
Nothing you need to worry about, Sith.
You are coming with me.
Don't get all sentimental. I just don't trust you to get the job done. Been waiting for this for 10 years. It
just time to do things the old-fashioned way.
I know what it meant for you to accompany me here, Candorus of Clan Ordo. Your trust honors me.
If you betray me or my men, I will kill you.
I was going to say the same, Candorus.
How about we kill some Sith instead? And from the job your men did out here, it looks like the two of you have some catching up to do. You're getting very good at cheating death, Tobin. It seems your new master isn't ready to let you die just yet.
I have served the wrong master. He cares nothing for Onderon, its soldiers, its people. Everything exists to feed his will. I came here, to this dead ship, and now he will not permit me to leave. This ship, it is a graveyard of a terrible battle. Everything on it slowly dies, as long as he hungers.
It is the way of all life that serves him. In his presence, all life dies.
This ship is from Malachor. This Sith Lord of yours bolsters his fleet with ships from that world. He's nothing more than a scavenger.
I think he is of that place. If so, then his power may be great indeed. Greater than I had thought.
Why did your master come here?
The master suffers. If he cannot feed, then the hunger begins to consume him. The planet, Telos, he may feed on something upon its surface to sustain him a while longer.
But there's nothing here. Telos is a near-dead world.
You think to lie to me still? I will not be deceived again. I told him, you know, what the old woman told me. I told him of the Academy here, of the Jedi here. I could not have kept it from him, even if I had wanted to.
old woman?
He means that Jedi witch you travel with. Kreia.
Yes. The old woman on Onderon. She spoke of the Jedi Academy here on Telos. And my master was forced to come here.
But there are no Force users here except us.
Then her lies will mean the planet's destruction. He will destroy all of Telos. He will turn it to fire again and crush the planet beneath him. He will devour them all, murder them all.
If there are no Jedi here, then my lord cannot feed his hunger. He will destroy the planet, the station. He will cleanse it of life. Even if the people below are not Force-sensitive, the small amount he can feed on from the mass destruction of the station and the life on the planet will sustain him a while longer. And if there are no Jedi below, he will have no other choice.
And if we deny him Telos?
Then he will suffer. Without something to sustain him, I do not know what will happen.
I think Kreia knows. If she leaked Telos to your master, maybe she wanted him to come here and find nothing.
He will create nothing. He will end this place. Your old woman has killed this planet, and with it, countless other worlds that depend on its survival. You cannot stop him. Nothing can. And you cannot escape either. If the Force runs through you, he will feed on it when Citadel Station dies.
Where is your master now?
On the bridge. He waits on the bridge. If you go to him, he will destroy you. And your last moment shall be of shadow and pain. Fight him if you will. But if he turns his power upon you, you will be destroyed.
If you would save Onderon, traitor, then listen to me. Once your master destroys Telos, then Onderon will be among those he will destroy next.
Onderon? But there's no longer any need.
He has touched Onderon, and he will come back for it.
You are right. As long as he exists, Onderon is in danger. The galaxy is in danger. What would you have me do?
Mandalorians are lining the ship with proton cores as we speak. We will need someone to set them off when we give the signal.
Go report to the target site, Colonel. I'll let my men know you're coming. And if you try anything stupid, they'll shoot you dead.
I will do as you ask, for Onderon's sake.
The Dark Lord is waiting. Once he is dead, I'm not sure how much longer the ship will hold itself together. Make sure you have those proton cores ready.
This door leads to the bridge and my former master. If you wish to gather your strength, this is the last time.
I am ready.
This thing must be done. It must come to an end.
I know. After you. Afraid of the darkness. You should be.
Thank you.
Do not be so quick to meet that which you do not understand.
Leave her alone. Kreia has lied to you. There are no Jedi here. Look past Citadel Station. The planet is barren. Surely you can sense this. No, it can't be, but how? Power, is that what you think it is? It's not true power if you rely on others to supply it. Even now, the hunger is consuming you, just as Kreia knew it would. You are nothing without the life force of others.
Yeah.
You must be prepared to sacrifice the Blinded One. Perhaps her death will buy you the time you need to deal with her master.
You are right. You are too powerful. I know that now. But I also know something else. You gain strength from another. One you share a force bond with. You and Visus are mentally bonded. If she dies, then so do you. I am sorry about this.
You must be prepared to sacrifice. You must be prepared to sacrifice the Blinded One.
Now, forgive me.
I cannot hold him for long.
That last move, can you teach it to me? Master is dead. There is nothing to maintain the whole integrity of the ship. We need to get out of here.
What the hell was that? I told you to wait!
Mandalore, we've made contact with the enemy, and one of the cores has detonated prematurely.
Was it in the target zone?
No, Mandalore. We have failed you.
Another core?
No, Mandalore. Three charges will not be enough to destroy the vessel. We need one more proton core.
He's right. Without another core, you will only disable the ship, leaving it at the mercy of Citadel Station's gravity. Fortunately, Visus and I passed by a missile bay on our way to the bridge. Your men should be able to reprogram one of them to serve as the final bomb.
All right. Wait for my signal. This isn't over. And don't kill yourself before I tell you. What the hell are you doing up there? We need to get off this ship. Now!
I have to see with the Force and my eyes.
What happens now shall not be done out of hate or revenge, but for the sake of all life. This body is a prison no longer.
What do you see?
A man, nothing more.
That's the last of them, Mandalore. We can destroy the ship on your command.
Are we ready? Mandalore has done his duty, Tobin. Now it's time to do yours.
Admiral Onasi wanted to speak with you, ma'am. As I understand it, there was something private he wished to ask you. Concerning a mutual acquaintance, I believe is how he put it.
Chodo, it is good to see you doing well. Moser told me what happened to you. Telos has suffered enough, Chodo. I'm just glad we were able to save it in your work here.
It's a little beat up, but it's still home. I wasn't able to be here to protect it when the Sith attacked the first time. This time you gave me a second chance. I owe you.
We meet at last, Admiral. I understand from Lieutenant Gren that it was you that arranged for my return to known space. Naturally, you have me wondering what the Republic could possibly want with an exiled Jedi.
I've read your records, how the Jedi sentenced you for doing what you believed. You wandered past the Outer Rim during your exile. I ask you, did you find any trace of Revan?
Revan? So that's what this is all about. No, I haven't seen Revan. Not since the end of the Mandalorian Wars. We didn't leave things on such good terms.
I served with him, like you did. And we had to part ways, like you did. He said that there were places where he had to walk where I could not go. Places where having allies or anyone he cared about would only place them in danger. It's been 4 years, and I still don't know what happened to him. He told me to stay here, to try to keep the Republic strong, and that he would return. It was the hardest request I ever had to follow.
Why did he ask that?
I don't know, but it was important to him. He said that he believed something had been behind the Mandalorian Wars. That it hadn't been the Mandalorian's choice to attack the Republic. Whatever it was, I think he went off to find it. To fight it.
Revan never mentioned any of this when we served together. Unless he had no memory of it.
We saved the Republic. But it was like the war didn't end for him. He would keep remembering things that he'd done and it kept driving him. And I think he finally remembered something terrible that he'd done during the Mandalorian Wars, and he went to put an end to it. But whatever he set out to do, I don't think he succeeded. And here you return, with his ship, without him.
Revan's ship?
Yes, wherever he went, your ship's been there. If you return to that place, if you find some trace of Revan, simply tell him that Admiral Onassi is following his orders. Safe journey, Exile.
Did she know?
No, she didn't.
There are times I fear we shall never know where he left, Karth. And I cannot live not knowing the answer. Why he sought to protect us.
He asked us to stay, to keep the Republic safe. It was important to him. And after meeting the Exile, I'm convinced that there are worse things to lose in the galaxy.
Travel here in search of work, and if we find a working arrangement, then I'm sure you could be included in.
I'm not here for any mercenary work. I'm here to return your clan to Duxon, where I am restoring our people to their former glory.
Mandalore? But after Revan defeated Mandalore, no new one was chosen.
I intend to rectify that error.
I have no doubt that you believe that you are Mandalore, but look at the situation we are in now. Anyone could buy a helmet from a swoop track and make such a claim. And the last time Mandalore traveled in the company of non-Mandalorians, we were pledged to Exar Kun.
I am no Exar Kun. I am a Jedi. And Mandalore speaks the truth. We are now allies.
A Jedi? Perhaps you are deserving of the title of Mandalore. I heard rumors from Isis about Mandalorian sightings on Duxon. So perhaps there is truth to what you say. Very well, Mandalore. My clan will follow you and make for Duxon, so that another clan might be added to the strength of your army. Excuse us. We must gather the rest of our clan and deliver them the news.
You helped me gather the clans together, so I feel I owe it to you to tell you the whole truth about my mission and Revan. After defeating Malak, Revan made the decision that he would travel to the unknown regions. He was searching for something. I wanted to go with him. I respected him. Knew he could use me where he was going. But Revan refused, saying that he must travel alone. Before he departed, he left me with a simple mission. He told me where I could find the Mandalore's helmet, and that I must take it and reassemble the clans. When I asked him why, he told me nothing, only that I should wait for him to return and be ready for it.
Ready for what?
Revan never said what he was looking for, or what to be ready for. I don't know if I'll ever know. I thought that Revan was a singular Jedi, but now there's you. With all our martial training, battles, and ethics, even our greatest warriors are no match for you. But I also have faith in my people. Should we need the clans to fight the Sith, we will. And afterward, Revan will still have his army.
That was quite a gamble you made back there. You put Telos and everyone on Citadel Station at great risk. You shouldn't have done that.
No? Perhaps not. You have been chased, hounded since our first meeting, and it has only made you stronger, more capable.
Are you saying this was a test?
I'm always testing you. Never forget that. Always be on your guard, otherwise you may learn something.
If you want to test me, fine. I agree to your help in stopping the Sith, but I will not use innocent people as collateral damage to do it. Do you understand?
Or what? Shall you kill me? Hurt me? You would only be inflicting harm on yourself.
I never said any of that. I just want you to be honest with me.
Very well. If it means so much to you, then this I swear to you upon my life, upon our lives. There shall be no more shadows between us, only truth that exists between master and apprentice.
I've fought countless battles, ones most didn't walk away from. The wounds add up, and even the implants are all that keep me going sometimes.
A real warrior knows his own limits and doesn't overestimate himself.
You fought valiantly, for the Republic and for your people. You've given Mandalorians everywhere a reason for hope. Are you sure you don't want to come with us?
What? You think I don't have something better to do? Let me give you some advice. Do yourself a favor and just head back from where you came.
You're serious? Sharing that helmet with the other Mandalores is making you vow? Literally.
Ha! Good one!
You're joking. I've never found your sense of humor very amusing. But I will miss it nonetheless.
This looks like the end of our partnership. I don't think I'm ready to give up this life of mine. This life of fighting. Not quite yet. We have things we need to do here.
I understand. If you ever change your mind, there will always be a place for you aboard the Ebon Hawk. Until we meet again, Mandalore.
You summoned me, my lord.
Does he live?
No, master. Darth Nihilus is dead. Kreia set a trap for the Dark Lord of Telos. The exile's strength is growing, my lord. It is only a matter of time until Kreia leads her to this place.
It does not matter. Kreia, I have come farther than any of her apprentices since Revan, and I am stronger for it.
You are stronger because you are Sith. You embrace the full power of the Force while the Jedi do not. They are short-sighted and they are weak because of it.
You were once Jedi. The last, the exile. You and her are alike, yet different in all the ways that matter.
I will show you just how different we are. Allow me to travel to Nar Shaddaa, my lord. The exile is searching for Zez Kael. One of the remaining Jedi Masters. She will seek him out as she did me, and I will be waiting.
Return to the surface. Travel to the Smuggler's Moon. Deny her what she wants.
Yes, my lord. I will leave at once.
exile. The end of the Jedi is at hand. She will break you, and when you do, you will die.
You know, I saw you eavesdropping back on Citadel. You seem very interested in what Mandalore had to say about Revan. You knew him, didn't you?
Perhaps. I think it is fair to say that few did.
Then you must know where he has gone.
No one knows, certainly not I. After defeating Malak, Revan left the Republic, and there are none who know where he has gone.
No, there are at least two people that do. Mandalore and Admiral Anassi both said that Revan went into the unknown regions, that he was looking for something. The Admiral believes that something else was behind the Mandalorian Wars, and that Revan went to find it. Something out there changed Revan, turned him to the dark side, caused him to return as a Sith Lord.
Is that what he was? Or was he always true to himself, no matter what personality he wore? And there is something that the Council may never understand, that perhaps Revan never fell. The difference between a fall and a sacrifice is sometimes difficult, but I feel that Revan understood that difference more than anyone knew. The galaxy would have fallen if Revan had not gone to war. Perhaps he became the Dark Lord out of necessity, to prevent a greater evil.
You believe Revan acted on his own? The reports I've read say the Council wiped his memory and gave him a new directive.
I do not believe the Jedi Council changed Revan, as they claimed. They merely stripped away the surface and allowed the true self to emerge again, someone who was willing to wage war to save others. But that is my belief, since I knew Revan from long ago, as a master knows their apprentice.
Apprentice? You trained Revan?
He came to me, yes, both before and after, before Revan knew himself. And after, in the times when Revan was coming to his own and learning he was more than he had been told. At one time, Revan was my Padawan, in times past, long ago. But Revan, when he had learned all he could, had other masters, that fool Zha, and other Jedi on other planets. He learned from each, but in the end, he turned back to me. When he realized there was nothing more to be learned from the Jedi, except how one could leave them forever. Where Revan wanders now, I do not know.
Statement. My memory core has suffered some damage. Statement. Yet somehow, a gap in my circuits makes me feel as if I should remember you. Statement. This is all the more important since during my routine inspection of all potential escape routes from this vessel, I made an interesting discovery. Observation. The navicomputer is voice locked. As a consequence, you are now responsible for course corrections and astrogation. Statement. That is indeed a great burden. It also raises many questions. Query. Why would someone lock the navicomputer? Answer. Presumably to hide where one has been. Statement. I believe you've been somewhere. Somewhere you wish to keep hidden.
Seem troubled, my lord.
Nyriss still refuses to take any real action. She tells me we must be patient.
Nyriss is driven by fear. Her immediate survival is more important to her than the fate of your empire.
There are powerful allies who could be persuaded to help her. All they need is someone to step up and take charge. A leader to spur them to action.
If she steps forward as a leader, she can no longer hide in the shadows with the others.
But if everyone is too afraid to step forward, he will never be stopped.
That is the way of the dark side. Those who follow it are driven by fear and ambition. They are too selfish to see that great victories often require sacrifice. You need to find another ally to your cause. Someone powerful, but who is not caught up in your politics.
You must be growing desperate if you think you can talk me into helping you escape.
We share a common goal, but I am not proposing an alliance. I do not need your help to escape. The Force has shown me that my freedom is drawing near.
The Force has shown you? Have you had another vision?
The Force has shown me that my future lies beyond these walls.
And what does your vision show you? How do you make your great escape from this dungeon?
You will understand. In time.
I have no wish to play your games.
Thank you.